Bonjour à tous. Je m'excuse, mais je vais faire la présentation en anglais. Thank you, everybody. My today presentation is titled Genetic Predisposition to Portosinusoidal Vascular Disease. Portosinusoidal Vascular Disease, or PSVD, is a rare liver disorder characterized by the involvement of altered intrahepatic vessels at the level of the sinusoids and the portal venule in the absence of cirrhosis. Each diagnosis requires liver biopsy to characterize different histological changes such as nodular regenerative hyperplasia, incomplete septal fibrosis, and obliterative portal venopathy. It affects young patients with a median age of 45 years old, and currently its evolution is unknown. As PSVD progresses, 10% or 20% of the patients among 2 years present portal hypertension and its complication, such as esophageal varices ruptures, in lower cases, gastrointestinal bleeding or ascites. And on the other hand, 50% of the patients also at 2 years of diagnosis, they present portal vein thrombosis. Also, the physiopathology of PSVD is unknown. To note, PSVD has been associated with different systemic diseases like HIV infection, immune and hematological disease, drug exposure, and genetic disease. In my presentation, I will focus on the genetic disease of PSVD. And I will show you some data compilation that we have been working on to identify PSVD genetic associated causes. We started with a screening in the public database PubMed and DigitNet by using different keywords, because PSVD nomenclature has been changing during the years. We found more than 200 genes associated with PSVD. And from this group, we excluded those cases report that present patients with acquired PSVD with underlying diseases and other patients that present a hepatic condition and features like hepatocarcinoma. We then focus on this of the proband that present a liver biopsy description congruent with PSVD. And we ended up with 32 genes that we split in two different groups. That in the first one, PSVD is associated to genetic syndromes. And in the other hand, we have rare gene mutations founded by whole exosome sequencing in patients with symptomatic PSVD. I will start first describing the PSVD manifestation in syndromic monogenic disease, starting with Adams-Oliver syndrome. This is a rare inherited disorder present at birth. And nowadays, there are 7 genes identified in the development of Adams-Oliver. Most of them are involved in the Notch pathway. And in the clinical manifestation of this patient, we can find aplasia cutis, cutis marmorata, terminal limb defects, and in some cases, some cardiac malformations. And in this table that I am presenting here, and that will be also presented in the throughout of my presentation, you can find the papers where the cases have been reported, the genes involved, and the number of patients carrying the mutation, the median age at PSVD diagnosis, and the frequency of clinical hepatic manifestations, such as splenomegaly, esophageal varices, ascites, and hepatic encephalopathy. And also, if there was some death related to liver complication or not. In the case of Adam Oliver, we found in the literature five cases reported where the median age of the PSVD diagnosis was at 2 years old in the children. And as a remark, all of them present esophageal varices, and 3 of them underwent gastrointestinal bleeding, causing the death of one of the patients. And also after splenomegaly was frequently observed. We then present some PSVD manifestation in telomeropathy disease. Just a quick introduction that the telomeres are DNA repeated sequence present at the end of the chromosomes, whose main function is to maintain telomere stability and to avoid its degradation. And the maintenance of telomeres require an enzyme that is called telomerase and other gene products that are involved in the telomerase assembly and recruitment. And any defect in one of those genes will lead to dysfunctional telomeres and to a wide spectrum of clinical condition. I will start describing those mutations that are underlined in this graph that affect telomere and sheltering complex. For these mutations, the patients present three main manifestations. In one group, we have premature hair graying, dystrophic nails, oral leukoplakia. We have also another main clinical manifestation, like lung fibrosis and bone marrow failure. And here, as you can see in the table again, we have the gene that has been described in the literature. And the median age of the PSVD diagnosis was young, 21 years old. Splenomegaly was systemically observed in this patient, where also a site was presented in some cases, and exophageal varices was either present or rare, and also encephalopathy was quite rare. And there was also some 26% of the liver that was of the death that was related to liver complications. Then also we have some mutation that are affecting the CST complex, like is the complex that is involved in the DNA's synthesis. And as a remark, this patient also in the literature has been described as Caut plus syndrome. And the clinical manifestation are similar to the ones that I described before for the other telomeropathies, with additional ocular symptoms like retinopathy and cranial calcifications. And for these mutations, we have six cases reported in the literature. And the outcome of this patient was more severe because 50% of the patient has died due to gastrointestinal bleeding. We found also PSVD manifestation in the gene-related immune deficiency. I will start first with chronic granulomatous disease, that is an immune disease that affects mainly the myeloid cells. The cells are impaired and cannot phagocyte or kill bacteria or fungal species. And in the literature, the most common bacteria affecting this patient was Staphylococcus aureus, and the fungal one was Aspergillus. And the clinical manifestation involves pulmonary disease with also lymphadenopathy with abscess and also lung abscess. And as a remark, in the literature, there is only two publications that analyze the same cohort of CGD patients. The median age of diagnosis of this patient was also young, around 19 years old. And as you can see, also splenomegaly was the most common clinical hepatic manifestation in PSVD. And there was not death related to liver complication, but there was death due to mortality for infection. And when they have the autopsy of this patient, 50% of the liver biopsies present history of ascites and splenomegaly. Then after, also PSVD manifestation have been observed in patients that present B and T cells deficiency, like Imbruton amaglobulinemia, activated Peitreska delta syndrome, common variable immunodeficiency, and these patients are also very susceptible to infection and have recurrent infection, both bacterial and viral. And they present also autoimmune associated manifestation and lymphoproliferation. And as a remark, for example, from the Bruton syndrome, there was a publication with 21 patients that only six of them present PSVD, and also it was a very young age with an splenomegaly as the first clinical hepatic manifestation followed by esophageal varices. And for the case of PH3K C-delta, we have a publication with 33 patients, with four of them present PSVD. In the case of the common variable immunodeficiency, it was already reported in the literature that in this disease, the patient presents some liver abnormalities, but this publication is the first one that describe a very young man that has died due to gastrointestinal bleeding. And also, PSVD had been observed in others monogenic disease, like you can see here, cystic fibrosis, cystinosis, Williams-Berlin and Turner. And in the case with cystic fibrosis, there is several reported, and the one last year from a review, where here you can see that also the median age of PFVD diagnosis was very young, and the frequency of the clinical manifestation was as presented before, with splenomegaly and esophageal varices very high, followed by ascite and some cases of encephalopathy, and 20% of the liver, the death was related to liver complications. For cystinosis, except for the first report, the others patient reported has underwent renal transplantation, and the PSVD diagnosis has been done in the follow-up of this patient. From the William Burren, we have only one case report, and for the Turner syndrome, that is caused by the total or partial loss of the X chromosome, and there is several reported that show that PSVD manifestations are observed in this patient, with also splenomegaly and esophageal varices as the main clinical manifestation. So if we go back to the flares, the first flare chart, I say also there was some rare gene mutation found in by whole exosome sequencing in symptomatic PSVD patients. And there is the list of all of these seven genes. As you can see here, the transmission of this gene has its autosomal familial inheritance. And again, the median diagnosis age of PSVD is very young, from 1 to 25 years old. And from those that has been reported, this specific two genes present an outcome a little more severe, with also the presence of ascite and encephalopathy. And another remark is that in this publication, once the authors found the mutation by whole exosome, they did some immune in vivo deletion of these genes, and they conclude that the liver manifestation observed was due to a causal of the deficiency of these genes. So once that we identified this list of genes, we were more interested to get more insight to better understand the implication of the genes in the PSVD development, and which type of cells or mechanisms are underlying this disease. So we start first with the cell type and tissue distribution of the gene expression that I mentioned so far. So using the Human Protein Atlas and dataset BioGPS, we can list all our genes and then compare the level of its expression in several groups, like blood and immune cells, liver, endothelial cells, and other. And to our surprise, it was not the liver or the endothelial cells where these genes present the highest expression. It was in the blood, in the cluster of blood and immune cells. So after we want to continue a deeper analysis in the immune cells that could be more effective for the mutation of these genes. And we, from the database, we can split the immune cells in the myeloid population and the lymphoid population. And for Adams-Oliver PSVD-related genes from immunodeficiencies, cystic fibrosis, cystinosis, Williams-Berlin, and the RET mutation, we found that the majority of the genes are more expressed in the myeloid cells in comparison with the lymphocytes. When we just compare the lymphocytes population that involve B cells, CD4, CD8, and natural killers, 5 out of 8 genes that were described in telomeropathies and PSVD manifestation are more expressed in this cluster. So this could suggest that immune response could be altered in the development of PSVD with the presence of this mutation. So after we want to analyze which pathways, if these genes are regulating in a common way several biological pathways, and we, using genontology database, we listed our pathway depending on the number of genes that that has been identified in the pathway listed. And as you can see here, for the first one, where more than eight genes has been implicated, we have three pathways that are in yellow that are related to immune response, and two pathways that are implicated in the cell morphology and differentiation. So finally, we were searching in the literature for in vivo genetic manipulation studies that will to gain more insight about which type of cells or what which process would be involved in this gene mutation and PSVD. And because of that, we just found not so, a lot of publication in cell-specific gene deletion. We found just three publications for some genes that were related to Adams-Oliver syndrome and to telomeropathy. And they used different transgenic mouse models where they, for example, for the first two, they specifically delete the target genes in the hepatocytes. And when they do that, there was no PSVD features observed in the liver, but for example, for the specific RAG1 deletion in the hepatocyte, there was an altered distribution and activation on immune cells in the liver. Also, same situation was observed in the lung and in the kidney. And for the DKC1 deletion in the liver, there was no PSVD feature, but some free vitamin reaction observed and senescence in the hepatocytes. And as a remark, as an interesting work, is that the immune cells deficiency of this gene related to telomeropathy provoke PSVD features in the liver phenotypes that was observed by a regeneration impair and also a vessel formation impair. So some take-home message is genetic mutations favor PSVD development, and we have two clinical scenarios possible. We have patients with monogenic syndromic disease that I listed before. So in this patient, a clinician should suspect PSVD development or PSVD as a potential liver manifestation in the lifetime of this patient. And in the other side, we have patients that present symptomatic PSVD with extrahepatic organ involvement that are young with or without liver disease. And this, in this group of patients, we highly suggest that genetic mutations screening should be performed, at least starting with NGS and then with whole exosome sequencing. And here is the summary of the genetic causes that I described today. In green is the one that are included in the panel of cholestasis, and in red in the one that is for the telomeropathies screening, and in the yellow one is the one that could be included in the normal NGS in the hospital. And finally, in the physiopathology of PSVD, after our analysis, blood immune cells arise as a possible cell that could be implicated in the PSVD development, with still without knowing which mechanism could be included. But it's open a new question that maybe the PSVD could be considered as an immune-related disorder. So thank you, everybody, and I would like to thank Liz Bertin, that is also here with me, and who is working also in this presentation and helping with a lot of...